This is what hiking and climbing with a camera looked like in 1927, when Ansel Adams made his famous image of Half Dome in Yosemite. In fact, that's Virginia Adams scrambling up the side there. It's a bit easier today, but it can still be challenging, as I'll tell you about with my recent trip with friends to the Grand Tetons in Wyoming. I'll tell you the story and pass along some tips to you along the way, too.
The thing to do when you're out shooting is you're mixing it up between natural shots, landscapes, and also just recording the events. You know, you want to remember what you took, so, or the trip that you took. So it's just a kind of a mixture between these two types of shots as you go.
The first day we hiked in about 7 or 8 miles and made camp. Woke up the next morning to find 3 inches of fresh snow in the middle of September. Wasn't what we were expecting, but hey, it was exciting and we made the most of it. I brought along a Sony a7 II that was loaned to me by B&H, and you can see I'm shooting a variety of stills and motion. That's the Grand Teton right there, poking out through the clouds. Here it is again. We're just capturing various images and weaving them together. When you get home, what do you do with all those pictures? Well, one thing you can do is put them into your editing software and piece together the motion and the stills, and have in a short period of time a really compact memory of that fantastic trip you took. And here we are traversing what's called Death Canyon. Pretty desolate, but it wasn't really a deathful spot. Waking up in the morning with all this mist coming off of Phelps Lake there, I thought that was pretty fantastic. Again, grabbing the motion of it and following it along, and boom, there was a still.
What happens for me as I get out, I get more in tune with different interesting points of nature, you know, like a tree growing out of a rock, or some sort of an interesting pattern, or the juxtaposition between a man-made object and natural, like with a bridge coming off, you know, the granite. I try to get a lot of those kinds of shots just because I find them interesting. But again, you're mixing up your shots with those kinds of landscapes and small details, with also just pictures of your friends and what's going on with the event so you remember it. It's just kind of a balance between the two all the way along.
We're headed back towards Teton Village and hence civilization, having had a really rich experience. One thing I can tell you is don't pack your camera away where it's hard to get at, because you're going to want to pull it out and at a moment's notice capture that video and capture those stills. Keep it close by. We had a fantastic experience. We got rained on, sleet, snow. We saw an avalanche. We heard a bear. It was hard, but it was really fulfilling, and it's great to have these images and video to show you and to bring back those memories and have them with us forever. I invite you to, next time you go out, take those images, put them together, create a little video, put some music behind it, and pass them along to your friends. Keep them as a visual diary. Remember to subscribe. We love it when you leave your comments, and also follow me on Instagram. I'm going to keep bringing you a lot of great photographs. And thank you for watching, and until next time, get out and capture your own images of life.